Hi, please click on subscribe button and hit the bell to get all the notification about learning and teaching. In this video, we are going to learn about the exception handling mechanisms in Spring Boot. Before jumping on to explaining this, let's have a clarification about the differences between an error and an exception. Okay, so an error is something wrong that has happened in the program and the program cannot progress further. It is a blocker. Whereas an exception is something that is not mandatorily needs to be addressed and program can progress even if the issue persists, right? So what we do is we handle that exception programmatically like a simple try catch in Java, right? So assume there is a error. So this error, you can compile it, you can compare it to a compile time error, right? So if you find a compile time error, can you progress with your program execution? No, you cannot. So what you do is you'll set and fix that compile time error and then you will hit the run, right? This is similar to that. Okay, an exception is something like you can, you know, handle it. Okay, it's like it's okay with an exception, you can continue the program execution. So what you do is you write a try catch block in Java and you will handle it. So I'll not go into the details of how to write an exception and all that stuff. Now let's quickly come back to the Spring Boot perspective. Okay, now from the Spring Boot perspective, assume your code has hit the exception. What will happen? This is a big question for us. So if exception occurs and your code doesn't take care of that, you actually need not worry because Spring Boot as a framework provides a default exception handling mechanism. So let's see the code snippet here. I have written a sample exception. Okay, and if you closely observe here you can see a status 500. Okay, and the error is internal server error. Okay, and message is like could not execute statement, some nested exception, blah blah blah, right? So for this, path is /users, looks like it's an REST call. Okay, so this is provided by Spring Boot by default. To display this kind of document, there is no need of creating a JSON document or a Java class. This is provided by Spring Boot framework itself. Clear? Okay. Now the question is how to handle the exception of a REST web services app built with Spring Boot. Okay. This is by default. Now, as a programmer, I cannot leave, you know, the program to have to give default exception for our customers, right? We want specific things on the customer side. Otherwise, customer would be left in dark and he will say the generic exception for the tech team and we will have to sit and debug the whole stuff. Instead of that, we will have a mechanism, error handling mechanism, that will give some specific message saying that this is the issue, right? Now, as I said, how to handle the exception of a REST web services app built with Spring Boot. Okay, this is very simple and easy. It's just that we need to follow a procedure. What is that procedure? Okay, the first thing and foremost thing you need to do is create a new class annotated with @controlleradvice. Okay, this is the annotation. And add a method, okay, that is annotated with @exceptionHandler. This is an annotation, okay, specifying which exception class this method needs to handle. That is all we are supposed to do. Okay, now let's see a sample. Okay, so I have written a sample exception handler. Okay, and I have a class. You can see the controller advice annotation is there annotated for this class called entity exception handler. Okay, and you have a method called response entity, and the method name is handle all exception, I beg your pardon, and it is annotated with @exceptionHandler. So if you closely observe, the value here is specified as exception.class. What is this exception.class? This is the name of the class file that is supposed to be handled. Okay, assume you have written your own Java class, for example, mytask.java, and that generates a mytask.class. Okay, and that Java class needs to be handled. So you will provide that class name here, okay, and that will be handled. Okay, so here I have a method called handle all exception, and this is going to handle our exception caused for that particular class. Clear? Okay, so the one more situation, let's try to see. So how to handle a custom type of exception happened at runtime, right? This is one more thing that we can have a look at. Okay, so if you have a look at this code, I have written a class file, a class by name myException, and we are extending a built-in class called runtime exception. Okay, and I have some static final, a variable serial version UID, and I have public myException, a constructor kind of a thing. Okay, now the next thing, so public class myHandler, okay, and we are writing a handler for this particular class. So this is our exception class and this is our handler class. Okay, handler class is something that is handling your exception. Simple. Okay, so this is extending response entity exception handler. This is a default class. Okay, again we are having an exception handler annotation, and you have your exception class written. Okay, and this is the format. Okay, here the class file should be my exception. Okay, so by this we can handle a custom type exception. To recap, first I explained what is the difference between an error and an exception. Then we try to handle any kind of exception using Spring Boot, and finally we explained how to handle your own custom exception by passing the name of the class. Okay, using these we can handle almost any type of exception you want, right? Thank you for watching this video.